The U.S. Air Force has announced that the B-52H Stratofortress, modified with the new APQ-188 Active Electronically Scanned Array, AESA radar, has been ferried to Edwards Air Force Base, California, on December 8. The bomber received the new system at Boeing's San Antonio, Texas facility as part of the B-52 Radar Modernization Program, RMP. The service says, "This milestone marks a significant step forward in the aircraft's ongoing modernization efforts to ensure it remains a critical component of the United States Air Force's conventional and nuclear long-range strike capabilities." The arrival also follows comments in August by Lieutenant General Andrew J. Gebara, Deputy Chief of Staff for Strategic Deterrence and Nuclear Integration, who said the service was very close to getting that first radar to Edwards Air Force Base to begin flight test. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how new APQ-188 AESA radar is set to bolster B-52. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The Boeing B-52 Stratofortress is a long-range subsonic jet-powered strategic bomber. The B-52 was designed and built by Boeing, which has continued to provide support and upgrades. It has been operated by the United States Air Force since the 1950s. Better performance at high subsonic speeds and relatively low operating costs have kept the B-52 in service despite the advent of more advanced aircraft, including the variable geometry B-1B Lancer and the stealthy B-2 Spirit. The B-52 upgrade program includes new engines, updated avionics, and structural improvements apart from the new radar. The enhancements will play an important role in keeping the B-52 operational till the 2050s or beyond. As the B-52 undergoes some of the most crucial changes in the H model's 61-year service life, the U.S. Air Force has designated the new variant as B-52J. The U.S. Air Force explained in a press release that a crew from the 49th Test Evaluation Squadron at Barksdale AFB, Louisiana, and the 419th Flight Test Squadron at Edwards AFB transferred the aircraft from Boeing's facility. Secretary of the Air Force Troy Mink said, "The ferry flight of this upgraded B-52 marks an important moment in our efforts to modernize the bomber force. This radar modernization ensures that the B-52 will continue to serve as a cornerstone of American air power well into the future. We are committed to extending the life of this vital platform, allowing it to operate alongside next-generation fighter and bomber aircraft." The service further described the radar modernization program as a key element of the broader strategy to modernize the B-52 as its planned service life now extends through 2050 and potentially beyond, as it becomes the long-range strike complement to the Air Force's newest strategic bomber, the B-21 Raider. U.S. Air Force Chief of Staff General Ken Wilsbach, "This milestone ensures our future airmen inherit a modernized, ready Air Force. The B-52 Radar Modernization Program is about more than technology. It's about readiness, deterrence, and the ability to fight and win. The B-52 remains a powerful example of how we fly, fix, and fight to sustain global strike capability." The Radar Modernization Program is set to replace the outdated APQ-166 radar, which received its last modernization in the 1980s. The new radar system is based directly on APG-79, developed for the U.S. Navy's F/A-18 Super Hornet fighter and EA-18G Growler electronic warfare aircraft. Manufactured by Raytheon, the radar is designed to excel in tracking multiple targets over extended ranges. APQ-188 has an open systems architecture and rugged commercial off-the-shelf RCOTS parts. Its array has solid-state transmit and receive modules for enhanced reliability, as well as an advanced receiver, exciter, ruggedized processor, and power supplies. The radar uses transmit-receive modules populated with gallium arsenide monolithic microwave integrated circuits. Raytheon officials explain that the radar's active electronically scanned array allows the beam to be steered at nearly the speed of light, dramatically enhancing situational awareness in both air-to-air and air-to-surface performance. This agile beam control enables the multi-mode radar to interleave functions in near real time, allowing pilots and crews to employ multiple modes simultaneously. By building on proven architectures, the U.S. Air Force sought to contain development costs while equipping the B-52 with a modern, fully capable AESA system. As Lieutenant General Gebara noted during a Mitchell Institute event in August 2025, the radar design was deliberately derived from the FA-18 system because it was already commercially available. He said, "It would actually cost us more if we asked to design a new radar." Boeing states that the radar upgrade incorporates two display and system sensor processors that serve as the mission computers, enabling full integration between the radar and the B-52's onboard systems. The aircraft also receives a pair of large 8x20-inch high-definition touchscreens at the navigator and radar navigator stations for radar imagery, system control, and legacy display functions, along with two fighter-style hand controllers for radar operation. The modernization package includes enhanced cooling infrastructure as well, featuring liquid cooling for the radar and bleed air heating to ensure reliable performance in extremely cold conditions. Viewers may note that U.S. Air Force will potentially spend $3 billion in acquisition for new components for the B-52. The program's funding profile reflects its multi-year procurement and integration plan, beginning with a $65.82 million request in 2024 to initiate early acquisition activities. Spending then ramps up significantly, with more than $1.1 billion allocated in both 2027 and 2028. Which represent the peak years for procuring and installing major upgrade components, including the new Rolls-Royce F-130 engines and the APQ-188 AESA radar systems. As evident, this upgrade is a major one. AESA radars bring significant advantages over mechanically scanned systems. Among these are increased detection range, improved resolution, greater resistance to jamming, and multifunctional capabilities that can also support electronic warfare. The sensor is set to greatly bolster B-52J's combat effectiveness.